So we're here doing a project update over at our Oceanview Square development here in Anchorage, Alaska. We were here last time getting the utilities stubbed in. As you can see, we've done some block work, getting the footings poured and the foundation in. We have one unit done, and we're working on doing the next unit today. I just wanted to run you guys through a few things about what goes into a footing and how critical it is to your home. It's part of the home that a lot of people don't get to see, because as soon as it gets done, it gets buried in the ground. And this is really critical to your home because it's what your house sets on, and it disperses all that weight from your home down into the ground, so it keeps it all together. So typical footings are about 16 inches wide, 10 inches high, and then we have rebar installed in those footings. And what that does is it increases the tensile strength of that concrete. Concrete has really good compression strength, meaning that when force is pushed down on it, it doesn't compress as much. But as soon as you get any forces that try and pull that apart, it doesn't perform very well. So we install this No. 5 rebar continuously throughout the footing to actually give it a lot more tensile strength so that you don't have breakage in the foundation. So the subcontractor we're working with today is Jackson Masonry. As you can see, these guys behind me, they're staging the block to get ready to put it up tomorrow after this footing gets poured. These guys are on top of it, the footing's not even poured, but the block's already staged, and they'll just be ready to rock and roll tomorrow. As you can see, there's 5 courses of block. One of the things that we need to do here at Anchorage is have a minimum of 42 inches of fill over the foundation. And that's just to make sure freezing doesn't happen underneath that footing, because if that happens, you'll get some heaving in the soils, and that will in turn create cracks or stresses on the concrete that you don't want. So once we have the block wall set, we'll come back and actually fill in all the cells of that block. And that's just typically done by grouting. They'll come and pump this all full. We'll install these J bolts into the top of the block so we can set our mud sill over top of that and then bolt it down to the foundation wall. So one of the code requirements is that the bottom of the footing has to be 42 inches below final grade. Unfortunately, not all lots are completely level, so sometimes you have to put steps in your foundation to allow for that 42 inches of cover over the bottom of that footing. So as you can see here, we have a 24 inch step in this foundation. So what the plan is, we're gonna slowly start taking this grade down right at this point. So we want to make sure we always maintain that 42 inches of cover below the bottom of this footing. So what we're going to do as soon as we actually pour the concrete into this footing is these will actually get set in, and then you're going to want to get them below that horizontal rebar and turn them so they lock in there underneath those horizontal pieces of rebar. And then what happens there is you come and you set the block on top of that and fill in those, grout those blocks, and it actually ties everything together. Thanks for checking out the video. I look forward to keeping you guys updated here at Oceanview Square. If you have any other questions or want to get more information, visit my website at visserconstruction.us.